Over the last month or 6 weeks, I've spent some episodes talking about seasonal employment, specifically retail seasonal employment. On this episode, I will give you the current job leads, and then I will tell you how to turn that seasonal job into a regular permanent position. It's the week of November 11th through the 15th, and this is the QC Step Podcast. Hi, and welcome to this week's episode of the QC Step Podcast. My name is Corey Finneran, and I am a transition specialist with the Step program. Don't forget that you can connect with QC Step on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. Go to qcstep.com/Facebook, and we are at QC Step on Twitter and Instagram. And these are other ways for me to get job leads to you. I share articles on employment, and I've been sharing photos from the Day of Transition conference. Speaking of sharing articles through our social network accounts and the Day of Transition conference, during the employer panel, Lisa Johnson from Dairy Queen said that she likes it when applicants turn in resumes with their applications, even if it's for an entry-level position. And there's an article with teen resume tips that I tweeted and I posted on our Facebook page. If you're thinking about applying for a job and you plan to write a resume, check out this article for a few tips. I did get the request from one of the schools that I should talk about resumes on the podcast, when to use them, when not to use them, how they should be attached to online applications, and other aspects of this topic. My plan is that on next week's episode, I will dive into the resume issue. Before we get into the main topic on this episode, though, let's look at this week's job leads. I post job leads to qcstep.com and on our social network accounts on Monday mornings, but this week's went up on Tuesday morning because of Veterans Day. All of these leads this week that I will give you have online applications, and you can find the links by going to qcstep.com, and they are listed under the post, Job Leads, November 12th, 2013. There are two Hy-Vee food stores that are hiring. Moline Store on Avenue of the Cities is looking for a produce clerk, and the Silva Store is looking for a bakery clerk. Trillium is a staffing agency. They're hiring warehouse clerks, and this is probably a position where you need to be 18. It didn't say that specifically, but most warehouse positions you need to be 18. Kmart in Davenport is hiring cashiers. Burlington Coat Factory in Bettendorf is hiring cashiers. UPS in Davenport is hiring package handlers, and Chipotle in Davenport is hiring crew members. Like I said, all of these leads have online applications, and if you would like help with these or any other applications, ask your STEP teacher, your co-op teacher, to contact Gary or Carrie, or you can email me, info@qcstep.com, and I will pass it along to Gary or Carrie, depending on which school you go to. Over the last month or 6 weeks, I've talked quite a bit about seasonal employment, specifically retail positions. On episode number 39, I gave you 5 reasons you should work a retail seasonal job. On episode number 40, I gave you 6 tips on finding seasonal employment. On episode number 41, I gave you 5 tips on filling out online applications. And on episode number 42, I gave you 4 tips on following up after applying. On this episode, I'm going to give you 5 tips on how to turn a seasonal position into a regular permanent position. Now, this information isn't just for those of you that may have gotten seasonal jobs this year. If you are working a permanent job, following these tips will also help you ensure that you are successful with that employment. In a study that I saw, 50% of employers that are hiring seasonal workers plan to turn at least some of that workforce into permanent employees. Being offered a position after a seasonal assignment ends, it's not chance and it's not luck. There are things that you can do to make employers and hiring managers identify you as someone that they would like to give a permanent position. And now I'll tell you how to make that happen. Tip number one for turning a seasonal position into a permanent position: work every day and don't be late. The reason that businesses hire seasonal employees is because they have more people walking through their doors. Businesses picking up and they just need help. Why would a manager or a store owner want or value someone that isn't reliable, they're not at work every day, or they're always late to work? They wouldn't. So if you want to showcase yourself and your work skills, you need to be at work every day and not be late for your shift. That is one of the easiest ways to stand out as a good employee. My second tip for turning a seasonal position into a permanent position is be flexible with your schedule. This may come as news to some of you, but with employment, the employer is not there for you, you're there for the employer. And what I mean by that is an employer hires you because they need work done, and they are letting you do the work for them in exchange for money. Around the holiday, businesses hire seasonal employees because they need more people working, and they need them at specific times. With being in school, your hours are already limited, and if you want to turn this into a permanent position, you need to make yourself available to work any time outside of school. If you tell an employer that you're available whenever they need you, they will appreciate that, and they'll remember it when it comes time to decide if you should be kept on after the holidays. To go along with that, being flexible with your schedule also means staying late if there's extra work that needs to be done. If you're not scheduled and you have a day off, it's possible that someone may be sick and the employer may call you to see if you would want to work the shift. If they call you and you say yes, then the employer was in a bind and you were the person that they could count on. Also, not only will this flexibility help you try to get a permanent position, but more hours means more money. So it's a win-win situation for both you and the employer. My third tip for turning a seasonal position into a permanent position is be flexible on the job. Just like an employer will appreciate your flexibility with your schedule, they will also appreciate it if you are willing to take on extra tasks while you're working. Be willing to take on projects that may not fall into your assigned role. Be the first to volunteer for extra tasks. You should always show initiative, and if you see something that needs to be done, don't wait to be told to do it. If there's a mess to clean up, go ahead and clean it up. The more you contribute, the more valuable you are. My fourth tip for turning a seasonal position into a permanent position is to give your best effort. Doing just enough is easy. Some people do this with seasonal jobs because they see seasonal employment as different than regular employment. You should treat seasonal employment like any other job. You're being paid to work. Part of giving your best effort is doing things like taking things seriously and learning the business. Learn how things work and try to understand the goals of the business. People that may have a say in who's being kept on after the holidays will notice if you start picking up on the culture of the business. Start using the right terminology. Small things like this will go a long way in making others see you as part of the team. Giving your best effort also means giving good customer service. 60% of employers say that taking charge and offering to help customers instead of waiting for the customers to ask for help is an excellent way to stand out from other seasonal employees. Customer service is extremely important all the time, but especially during the holiday season. So give the best customer service that you can, and your chances of being kept on after the holidays are much greater than if you provide poor or even just average customer service. And my fifth tip for turning a seasonal position into a permanent position is to make your desire to be kept on after the holidays known. If you're proving your worth and you're following these other tips, don't be scared to let it be known that you would like a permanent position. While you're working, network. Introduce yourself to the decision makers. Say things like, "Thank you for the opportunity to work here during this holiday season, and I would be interested in working here permanently, so if there's anything that I can do to help make that happen, please let me know." I promise that if you say that to a manager, they will remember you, and they will remember what you said. So those are five tips for turning a seasonal position into a permanent position. Basically, take seasonal jobs seriously. Say yes and work hard. This is a very stressful time for business owners and managers, and the last thing an employer wants to do during this busy time is to have to worry about if their employees are working hard and doing what they're supposed to do. And let's say that a permanent position just isn't there after the holidays. If that's the case, the worst case scenario is that you've been a great employee, and when you use that employer as a reference, they will have many great things to say about you as a worker. I tell you these things now because if you are working a seasonal position, you're probably just starting with that job, and it's best to do these things from the beginning of your employment. Establish yourself as a good and valuable employee from the very beginning. And value is really what it comes down to. Maybe the employer isn't sure if they have a spot for you after the holidays. If you want to be valuable enough that they just can't let you go after the holidays, then follow these tips. And like I said at the very beginning, really every one of these tips is something that will help you be successful with any job, not just seasonal jobs. So work every day, don't be late, be flexible with your work schedule, be flexible on the job, and give your best effort. And if you do these things, I guarantee you that you will have great chances of having successful employment. Well, that does it for this week's episode. Again, my plan is to talk about resumes on next week's episode. And if you have a specific question about resumes, tweet them to me at QC Step, post them on our QC Step Facebook wall, or you can email them to me, info@QCStep.com. Thanks for watching, listening, and downloading, and I will be back next week with another episode of the QC Step Podcast.